So I think we can begin the afternoon session. So I am glad to introduce Ali Messaoudi from the State University of São Paulo in San José Rio Preto. We will speak about the property of stochastic adding machine. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. I am very happy to be here, and I would like to thank the organizers for this very nice conference. Then today we speak about some dynamics properties of a class of linear maps. And precisely I will speak about the class of linear maps are transition operators of stochastic adding machine. Then let us consider X as a separable Banach space. And T, a linear map from X to X, linear continuous map. Then let us consider the dynamical system XT. Then the dynamical system of linear maps is more or less old, but it was it has many progress in the years 80. And there are two important notions that are supercyclicity and hypercyclicity. Then we say that T is hypercyclic if T is topologically transitive. That means that there exists a dense orbit. And we say that T is supercyclic if there exists X in X such that the projective orbit of X, that means lambda Tn X, N in N, and lambda in C, is dense in X. Okay, and there is a characterization of hypercyclicity and supercyclicity, a classical characterization, that is T is hypercyclic if and only if for every U, F, and V non-empty open sets, we have the resist N in N such that Tn U inter V is not empty. And the characterization of supercyclicity is the same thing, just we must multiply by lambda. Resist N, resist lambda in C such that lambda Tn U inter V is not empty. And of course, for this, the equivalence between hypercyclicity and the characterization of hypercyclicity, we don't need to have a linear map. Just a continuous. Okay. Then, question. Give me examples of hypercyclic or supercyclic operators. If X has finite dimension, I consider a finite matrix, request is negative. It is not hypercyclic nor supercyclic. FT is compact operator or normal. Also, it's negative. But an example where it is the request is positive, for example, if we take X, the set of holomorphic functions, and we take the operator derivative, it will be hypercyclic. Then another thing important that the dynamics of linear maps, it is it can be very interesting because of a theorem of Feldman that tells that there exists a Banach or an Hilbert space X and T linear continuous map from X to X such that for every KF, where K is a metrizable compact set, and F from K to K continuous then for every KF satisfy this, there exists Y subspace of X invariant where Y is a compact such that the dynamical system KF is topologically conjugated to Y T. This is a very strange result. This implies that the dynamic of linear continuous map can be interesting. Now, let us take an example. Let us consider the shift operator acting in L2 to L2. Take an element in L2, xi to xi plus 1. I will denote it by T. Then we can represent T by the infinite matrix, where we have 0 everywhere, and we have 1 up to diagonal. Then one question, is T hypercyclic? The request is T hypercyclic, then the request is no, because the norm of T is 1. Then this implies that for every X, norm of TX is less than norm of X, then norm of TNX is less than X, then TN for every N, then TNX cannot approach 2X, for example. Other question, is T supercyclic? Or lambda T, now if I take lambda T, where lambda is greater than 1, is lambda T hypercyclic? It's a very good exercise. Then to prove this, it's not so easy. And we have a very efficient criterion called criterion of hypercyclicity. This criterion tells the following. If you consider t from x to x linear and x continuous and x Banach separable space, t satisfies hypercyclicity criterion if there exist two subsets of x, t1, t2, contained in x, dense, and there exist a sequence of maps from d2, sequence of maps that I will call Sn, from d2 to x, such that one, the norm of Tnx go to zero for every x in D1. Two, the norm of Sny go to zero for every y in T2. And three, Tn Sny converge to y for every y in D2. Then when the map T satisfies this, we call that it satisfies criterion of hypercyclicity. And okay, here in fact we don't need all. We can use just a subsequence SnK. And the maps SnK must not be linear. They are maps. And this criterion is very, very efficient. And if we have this criterion theorem, T satisfies hypercyclicity criterion in place that T hypercyclic. And this criterion, it's very easy to prove this theorem, because to prove this, you consider two open sets U and V, and you intersect U with D1, with the set D1. And V with the set D2. D1 and D2 are dense sets. And you take X in U inter D1 and Y in U in V inter D2. Then you do this, inter D1, Y in V inter D2. Now you consider ZK equal X plus SnK Y. This ZK, when K goes to infinity, converges to X because SnK goes to zero in norm. Then ZK will be close to X. Then ZK will belong to U for K large. And now, if you consider Tnk of Zk, we'll use the linearity, it will be Tnk of x plus Tnk Snk of y. And this converges when k goes to infinity, Tnk of x goes to zero, and Tnk Snk of y goes to y. Then Tnk to Zk will be close to k to y for k large. Then it will be long to v. Then what we prove that Tnk u inter v is not empty for k large. Then it's very, very easy to prove this theorem. And during many time, it was believed that the inverse is true. And recently, it was proved that it is not true, and that T satisfies I got HC if and only if T star T is transitive. Okay. Now I will apply this in the case of shift, this criterion, in the case of shift. Huh? I don't remember the name. If I think that Nilsson, who from? Huh? Paris. Okay, thank you. Okay. Now, how to apply this theorem to prove that lambda s, lambda t, is hypercyclic for lambda greater than 1, where t is the shift map. Then you will take d1 equal d2 equal d, where d is just the set of sequences where xn equals 0 exists n such that xn equals 0 for all n greater than n. This set is dense. D is dense in L2. And now, OK? Now it is dense. Of, now you take you T prime. I will denote it by lambda T. I would like to prove that T prime is hypercyclic. Then now, if I take x in D, T prime n equal lambda n T n of x. X is just x0, x1, etc. But as x belongs to D, we know that xn equals 0 for n greater than big N. Then this term will converge to 0, where n goes to infinity. And now we must construct the sequence, the maps Sn. The maps Sn, what is the map? We consider S prime is lambda minus 1 S, where S is just an inverse of the shift map. That means S of x0, x1, etc. equals 0, x0, x1, etc. Then if you compute S prime n, it will be lambda minus n Sn. And we will have exactly that T prime n, S prime n, of x equal x. Then we will satisfies the criterion of hypercyclicity. Observe one thing, that the criterion of hypercyclicity is satisfied with the whole sequence n in n, not by a subsequence. In this case, it proves that T is not only hypercyclic, but mixing. Because if T satisfies this criterion with nk equal n, this implies that that the operator is topologically mixing. Excuse me, I am speaking a mixing of English, Portuguese, and French, but okay. And there is another criterion of supercyclicity. It's exactly the same. The unique thing, then we say that T satisfies supercyclicity criterion If there is day one and day two such that, here we must change one and two by one, and we must put tnk x snk y. The product goes to zero for all x in day one, y in day two. And the second is this. And when we have t satisfying criterion of supercyclicity, this implies that t is supercyclic. OK. Now I will speak about our operators, the operators that I tried to study. Then the operators that I tried to study with, in collaboration with Patricia Cirillo, El Abdallawi, and Glauco Valli, is the following. Let us consider an integer n in n and write it in base 2 with digits 0 and 1. For example, if I take 3, it's 1, 1. Now, I will add 1. I will do the adding machine. Then when we add 1, there is an algorithm that we learned many years ago. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 modulo 2 is 0. And I will have a carry. How I compute the carry is just 1 plus 1, 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. And I will check the integer part of this. Then it will be the carry. Now I do the same. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 modulo 2 is 0. The carry will be 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 modulo 2 is 1. And the carry will be 1 divided by 2. I check the integer part, it will be 0. And after the carry will be always 0. Then we have an algorithm given by the following way. Assume that I know the digits of n, epsilon I n, and I construct the digits of n plus 1 by epsilon I plus 1 is just epsilon I n plus the carry n plus 1, modulo 2. And the next carry, the first carry, the initial carry is 1. It's this number. Then, knowing the epsilon I n, I will construct epsilon I n plus 1. And the next carry will be, say, I n plus n, will be just this term, plus I minus 1, n plus 1. And I divide it by 2, and I take the integer part. This algorithm gives us the digits of n plus 1. Now, assume that this algorithm does not run well, then Killing and Taylor. Killing is a psychologist and Taylor a mathematician. They defined the stochastic adding machine by considering a sequence of random variables, IN, Bernoulli, which is 1 with probability P and 0 with probability 1 minus P. And they multiplied the carry by this variable. And they assume that A, I, N are independent. Then what happens? For example, if I consider 0, 0, if I add the carry to 0, it will be 1 with probability P. Then I will go to 1 with probability P. If I don't add the carry to 0, that means that the first A0N is 0, I will stay in 0 with probability 1 minus p. Now, assume I will take 1. If I don't add 1, I will stay in 1 with 1 minus p. If I add 1, I have 0 with probability p, and I have a carry. If I add the carry next, I will have 1 with another probability p. Then I will go to 1 to 2 with probability p2. And now, if I add in the first one, I have 0 with probability p, I have the carry. If I don't add it, then it will stay 0 with probability 1 minus p. Then I will go from 1 to 0 with probability 1 minus p. And we continue this. OK? It seems that this stochastic adding machine has applications in psychology, because Killing and Taylor wrote 2 papers, one in psychology and the other in nonlinearity. And they proved the following. Here we obtain a Markov chain, and now they consider the operator of transition T of this Markov chain. That means the matrix T is just PIG, where PIG is the transition probability from I to G. For example, this matrix will be the coordinates, the coefficients will be P00 is 1 minus P, P01 is P, and here 0, etc. Here, for example, in the diagonal, we will obtain 1 minus p, 1 minus p. OK. And this operator of transition have many properties. It is a bistochastic infinite matrix. OK. And now, Killing and Taylor proved the following. Huh? Ah, okay. The second one is here, for example, P10 is just P1 minus P. Here, 1 minus P, here P2. There's 0, 0, 1 minus P, P. What we have? We have in the diagonal 1 minus P, we have this matrix. It have the diagonal, and after we have a non-zero line, and after we have 0. That means that pi I plus 2, I plus k greater than or equal to 2 is 0. And we have a block here that it is repeated. Here we have 1 minus p. P1 minus P. We have the same matrix here in the middle, but we have other things, no zero here. This operator, he has norm 1. And Killing and Taylor proved the following theorem, that if you consider X an element of C0, C, L if T, LK, K greater than 1, the spectrum is always the same, and it will be the field Julia set of a quadratic map, such that Z in C, such that F and Z bounded, where F to Z is Z minus 1 minus P divided by P. And what happens, the spectrum here, when p is equal to 1, when p is equal to 1, we have the shift map. When p is equal to 1, we obtain the disk. And after when p move, we obtain some fractal things. And when p equal to 1 half, we obtain an interval. And after we obtain, when p is less than 1 half, we obtain a Cantor set. OK? And another thing is that For example, in LFT, the spectrum is equal to the set of eigenvalues. But in the other spaces, the spectrum, the set of eigenvalues is always empty set. And the spectrum is equal to the continuous spectrum. For all the other space, but for L1, it's difficult. It's different. Okay. Okay. Question: how about hypercyclicity and supercyclicity of this kind of operators? One thing obvious that T is not hypercyclic because the norm of T is less one. Is not. Now, how about the question of lambda T hypercyclic or T supercyclic? And we have the following theorem with Cirillo Abdallawi, Vali, and myself, that if P is greater or is less than 1/2, the request is negative. That means lambda s no hypercyclic, and for every lambda greater than 1, and lambda t and t no supercyclic. In x, where x belongs to the set of C0, CLK, K greater than 1. OK. Now, if P is greater or equal to 1/2, also a no, the request is no in L1. And in the other space, C0, CLK, K greater than 1, we don't know. We think that it will be, the answer will be no also, but we couldn't prove this. I will give you the idea of the proof, because the proof is spectral. Then idea, we will use the following lemma. The lemma tells that if T is hypercyclic, implies that for every connected component of sigma t, C inter the unit circle is not empty. And the other one, t is supercyclic, implies that the same thing, that there is R greater than 0, such that for every C connected component, C inter the circle of radius center 0 R, the radius R, intersect C. Then this using these lemmas, it becomes very, very easy to prove for example, in the first case, if P is less than 1/2, what happens? We can prove that the Julia set, that the spectrum of T, is a Cantor set. And the spectrum of T, it has T is a stochastic matrix. It has 1 in its boundary. And also it has another fixed point here. Remember that I am dealing with lambda t. Then the spectrum of lambda t, it will have lambda and another point. Then what happens? We cannot, and another thing, lambda and the other fixed point are connected components because it is a Cantor. Then we cannot, and they don't intersect the circuit say, 0, 1. And using the second property, we can prove also that it is not supercyclic. Now, one question, how to give the same proof, for example, without using this spectral lemma and characterization? And of course, because we are thinking to the case where we don't know nothing here, because here, when in this case, if p is greater than 1/2, the spectrum is connected. Then we cannot separate the connected components. It's for this reason we don't know to do this case. That means p greater than 1/2. And x belong here. But in L1, we can do this. We know to solve this problem in L1 because we prove that the spectrum, the point spectrum of the adjoint of T in the dual of L1, empty, is not empty. And we could prove that, in fact, it will be a countable subset of the boundary, a countable dense subset of the boundary. And this, it is sufficient to prove that it is not supercyclic and the lambda t is not hypercyclic because there is a lemma that tells that if t hypercyclic implies that the spectrum pontois of t of the adjoint of t is empty, and if t is supercyclic, it is empty, or it is in fact it will be contained in one point. It will be empty with just one point. But here we will have the spectrum, point spectrum will be an infinite number of points. Okay, now then it seems that the request of this question is negative. Now what can we find some hypercyclic or supercyclic operator? Now, let us take the Killing and Taylor operator, and instead of considering one P, we consider a sequence of PI. That means that the algorithm of adding one here, epsilon I n plus the carry, modulo 2, and here the next carry is the same thing divided by 2, the integer part. Here I multiply by AIN. Now, my sequence AIN is just 1 with probability PI, and 0 with probability 1 minus PI. That means I am changing the probability at each stage. Then in this case, with Glauco Valli and Olivier Sester and myself, we proved that if we consider the Markov chain, we proved that those two things, the two spectrum of the operator is equal to the Julia set, the Fibre-Joyler set. That means is the set of Z in C such that Fn, Fn minus 1 until F1 of Z bounded, where Fn equals Z minus 1 minus P sobre P, Pi, Pn, 2. And the second thing, we proved that T is null recurrent if and only if the product of Pi is 0 and T is transient, otherwise T is transient. Then now, how about these operators? What we proved with Cirillo, El Abdallawi, and Valli, that in the case where the spectrum is a Cantor set, it's easy. It will, the request is no. But now, in L1, if the operator if T is transient, the request will be positive. That means that lambda T will be upper cyclic and T will be supercyclic. And to prove this, we proved the criterion of using the criterion of supercyclicity. And one thing very, very important here is that in this case, we have that to do. Point spectrum of T is not empty. And this was very important because we have the K of T is not empty, and we have that D will be, we will take D as the union of K of T n, and this sequence of kernel is increasing, and this set will be dense, and will be our set. And now in the other space, if we work with LK, K greater than 1, here we will have something, we will have that the request will be positive in the case where sum of minus Pi K is less than empty. Otherwise, we think that the request is negative. And this problem can be generalized to others adding machine. For example, we can, instead of considering Bayes 2, we can consider Bayes of Fibonacci. And we can do the stochastic adding machine, but now we must do it using transductor. And we construct a transductor, and after a probabilistic transductor, and after we have a stochastic operator. But the problem here, in this case, the spectrum of the operator, T, when we deal with Fibonacci, it will be the set of, it will be connected to the Julia sets of maps from C2 to C2. We have that spectrum of T is just the set when I change the probability of F1n, Fn minus 1, until F1 zz, for example, bounded, where Fe of xy, Fn are maps from C2 to C2, of the form xy plus 1 minus pi divided by pi, and here's some x. Then Danilo Caprio proved this. And for this case, how about the two questions of supercyclicity and lambda t hypercyclic, the question seem more complicated, because in this case, the spectrum can be what we can prove that when p is when the p e are less than some constant, we can prove that the spectrum is disconnected. Just this, we could not prove that it is homeomorphic to Cantor set or something. But in this case, for this Markov chains, when the pi are very close to zero, Danilo Caprio proved that the chain can be positive recurrent. And in this case, the request will be negative. And I will stop here.